Hi, I'm Shalhebit Barashair, Director of Product Management for RefWorks. Next time you open RCM, you will see a brand new interface, which is part of the latest version we released. This version was developed in part based on feedback we heard from you, our customers, and we are excited to walk you through it. The latest RCM provides a better, sleeker interface with additional menu options, a faster experience since it loads, syncs, and updates faster, and support of Word 2016, Word 2019, and Word Online, which you'll see in action, for both Windows and Mac. All this makes RCM the better choice if you're using Word 2016 and above. Let's take a look so you can see for yourselves. Over to you, Gloria.
Thank you, Shalhebit. Hi, my name is Gloria. I'm the RefWorks UX designer, and I'd like to walk you through some of the new features. As Shalhebit mentioned, the new interface is sleeker and better organized. It was also designed with performance, usability, and accessibility in mind. Let me give you a quick overview. One of the first changes you'll notice is that RCM is now conveniently located in the ribbon. This shortcut to RCM will be available each time you open Word. After you click on the tab, click the RefWorks icon to launch RCM. The current citation style is displayed at the top. This allows you to quickly make sure you're using the intended style. Now let's select the reference to cite. At the top of the preview window, you'll see information regarding the formats available for the currently selected citation style. Chicago 17th edition, for example, supports both in-text and footnote citation formats. Editing citations with multiple references is now more user-friendly. Let's add another reference and take a look. To edit this citation, click Edit. Now when you edit, all the citation's references are displayed on one screen, making it easier for you to keep track of which reference you're editing. Let's go ahead and insert the citation. If you make any changes to the references in your RefWorks account, and you already have RCM open, simply click the refresh button located in the bottom right corner to update your reference list. Refreshing the reference list ensures that you are looking at the most up-to-date information in your RefWorks account. Now let me walk you through some of the options available in our main menu. Click on the icon in the upper left corner to access the main menu. Let's take a look at the Change Citation Style section. A preview of available formats is displayed for the selected style. As you can see, Chicago 17th edition supports both in-text and footnote citation formats. When both formats are available, in-text citations are selected by default in the preview window. If you'd like to default to footnotes, click this checkbox. Now let's return to the main menu. You can turn the bibliography on or off in this section. Notice that when we inserted our citation earlier, the bibliography did not automatically appear. That's because the bibliography is off by default. When the bibliography is turned on, each time there is a change in the citations in your document, your bibliography will be updated. Having the bibliography off is helpful for those working on a document containing a large number of citations, as it reduces update times. You now have the ability to change the language within RCM to one of the languages available in RefWorks. Changing the language here will change it in RefWorks as well, and vice versa. And lastly, we've added a link to make it easier to reach out to support if you experience any issues.
Thank you, Gloria, for that excellent walkthrough. We're excited to start the new year with an overhauled RCM version that will make paper writing much easier. We'll be adding features to RCM throughout the year. In the meantime, if you have features you would like us to consider, please submit them in the RefWorks Idea Exchange. Bye!